So DJI has just announced the new Mavic 3 Enterprise series, the Mavic 3 T and the Mavic 3 E.
The new drone comes in two versions, the E version, which has a mechanical shutter intended for mapping and inspection, and the T version for public safety use and more. Today we are testing the thermal version.
Let's start off with a quick comparison with the latest DJI Enterprise products. Here you can see the M300, the M30T, and the new Mavic 3 T. The Mavic 3 T, being the smallest, weighs in at 920 grams and is the same size as the Mavic 3. When folded, it's easy to take with you and everything you need fits in the hard case. This drone does not have an IP rating, and it's intended for fair weather use. It can handle wind speeds up to 12 meters a second, and the max flight time is listed to be 45 minutes. The M30T weighs around 3,700 grams and can be folded and is small enough to fit most places. This drone has an IP rating of 55 and can handle wind speeds up to 15 meters a second. The max flight time is listed to be 41 minutes. The M300 weighs around 6,300 grams with two batteries and can carry up to three payloads. This is absolutely the powerhouse of the Enterprise series and can be used to complete a wide variety of tasks. With an IP rating of 45 and wind speeds up to 15 meters a second, the max flight time is listed to be 55 minutes with no payloads on. Let's take the Mavic 3 Thermal outside to test it. Inside the hard case you will find the drone, the RC Pro, cables, 100 watt charger and props. There is also room for the loudspeaker and RTK accessories. The drone has a new and improved gimbal cover that is easy to take off. Unfold the drone, insert the battery, and it's ready to go. On top there is a navigation beacon, a PSDK port for accessories like the RTK module or loudspeaker. Underneath there are landing lights. They will automatically come on under low light conditions. The RC Pro is the improved version of the smart controller with customizable buttons. Power on with a press and press and hold. Underneath you will find the micro SD card slot, USB-C and HDMI. And on the back side you have additional customizable buttons. The RC Pro comes with the Pilot 2 app installed. Power on the drone with a press, press and hold. Before takeoff, there is a pre-flight checklist where you can set things like max altitude, return to home altitude and more. The app has a status bar on top, radar and flight information at the bottom. You can change cameras on the left. The map is at the bottom left. Record and camera settings is on the right. Start the engines by pulling both sticks down and in. Let's take a closer look at the camera. A 48 megapixel wide camera, a 12 megapixel zoom camera with 56x hybrid zoom, and a 640x512 thermal camera. The wide camera gives you an overview of your operations area, and the green square in the middle indicates where your zoom camera is zoomed in. There is also an H mark on the screen indicating where you took off. The zoom on this drone is really good. You can zoom in with the app or use the zoom wheel on the RC Pro. The zoom on the M300 and the M30 is a lot better, but this is still impressive. Zooming in lets you see details up close without having to risk flying close to the object. In thermal mode, you can hit the side-by-side button to have both thermal and zoom camera on screen. If you then hit zoom link, you can zoom in with both cameras at the same time. The thermal camera can be used to find people, detect hotspots, and more. With different color palettes, you can choose the one you need for the task ahead. Draw a box with your finger to show the hottest and coldest point. There is a function called Discrete Mode where you can turn off all lights. You can find this in the menu. This is practical if you don't want to attract attention, and it's intended for law enforcement use. The Mavic 3T comes with a 360 degrees omnidirectional obstacle avoidance. Watch as I fly close to the training tower. You can see the radar at the bottom change first to yellow and then to red, indicating that I am close to something in front of the drone. Turning left, you can see that the radar changes accordingly. This makes this a very safe drone to fly if you need to fly in tight situations. To sum up this video, this is a great drone for public safety use and for inspections. The size and the price makes this a good start. If you need a waterproof drone and have the budget for it, I would definitely go for the M30T. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you have any thoughts or questions, please drop them in the comment section below.